Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 946, and today's topic is the properties of latex and coagulation of rubber. So the latex is actually the milky liquid which is extracted by incision of the rubber plant. And mostly the rubber plants, by incision, they give 5 to 6 gram per day, and in 1 year we can get roughly 2 kilogram of latex. Latex is suspension, is colloidal, and it is the mixture of isoprene unit, and it is hydrocarbon, C5H8, along with fat and protein. And here the droplet of this hydrocarbon is suspended in aqueous mixture, and this droplet is in millimicron size, very small, and they are again treated with ammonia and then stick acid to coagulate it. That then coagulation will take place, and after the coagulation the rubber portion, that is 60%, will be separated out from other impurities like protein and fat and watery material, and all these latex contains 25 to 35% coagulated material, that is rubber, and that is finally purified. So this coagulation is the process by means of which the isoprene C5H8 polymer, that is rubber polymer, is separated out, and that is called crudite. So all these I am going to give one by one. So as I have already told you that latex is emulsion, is colloidal solution, and it is the emulsion of water, protein, isoprene, that is your polymer hydrocarbon, and it is given here. Number one, latex is an emulsion of polyhydrocarbon droplets. Polyhydrocarbon is actually isoprene, that is C5H8, and that C5H8 is a single unit monomer, and that will combine in millions in head tail fashion, and that will give the polymer of isoprene. That's why the rubber is also called polymer of isoprene. A droplets in an aqueous solution, for example, it is colloidal dispersion of negatively charged particles of rubber. So it is a droplet of negatively charged particle of rubber, and that rubber is polymer of isoprene unit C5H8, and that is about 1,000 millimeter, 1.2 micron in diameter, and looks like white milk. It looks like white milk. It is a milky substance. Number two, the charge on rubber particle is responsible of stabilizing it. So stabilized to emulsion. So because of charge, negatively charged particle on, that is polyhydrocarbon, that is isoprene, the rubber is stabilized, and that stability is forming actually emulsion. The percentage of rubber in it is from 25 to 35%. Latex is collected by trapping the tree in such a manner as to allow the milky liquid to accumulate in small cups, and which must be collected frequently to avoid any putrefaction or contamination. So putrefaction and contamination should not be there, and if it is left for some time, then there is chance of putrefaction and contamination. Number three, a fully grown hevar tree, that hevar tree is commonly known as rubber tree, gives about 5 gram of rubber. It gives about 5 gram about 5 grams of rubber in a day and about 1.7 kilogram of rubber in a year. This latex has following compositions. The water percentage is 60. It contains 60% water. Rubber hydrocarbon 35%, protein, nucleic acid 3%, fatty acids and ester 1%, inorganic salt 0.5%. The composition of latex varies with different parts of trees. The percentage of rubber latex decreases from the trunk to the branches, and in the tree rubber is formed from the C5H8, and that is called isoprene unit, by biochemical reaction in which a particular type of enzyme, it is actually enzyme reaction, and that enzyme reaction in plant, biochemical reactions are catalyzed by organic substance that is called enzyme. So in the presence of particular enzyme, this isoprene unit is synthesized inside plant, that is C5H8, and that finally gives the polymer in the form of isoprene polymer, and that is your rubber. Isoprene unit by biochemical reaction in which a particular type of enzyme acts as catalyst. The more latex is removed, the more plant generates it. So if you are removing more latex from the plant, it will go on producing, releasing more latex. So now the process of coagulation is very important process. When the latex is collected from the rubber tree, then first we are adding the preservative in order to protect it from any chemical reaction or fermentation. So ammonia is added as a preservative, and after that then it is treated with acetic acid, and treatment with acetic acid and where pH is maintained between 4 to 5. If suppose it is more acidic, then we will not get coagulation, and coagulation means rubber hydrocarbons. So all these factors we have to maintain. Here, number one, coagulation of rubber. The latex collected from the tree is strained, and preservative ammonia NH3 may be added, and the rubber is then separated from the latex by the process known as coagulation, and which is affected by the adding of acetic acid. So the coagulation is done in the form of coagulation means precipitate form will be there due to the process of coagulation, and that coagulation is done by acetic acid to the dilute latex. The result of addition of acetic acid, the rubber hydrocarbon, which is main dispersed phase, gets coagulated in the solid form known as crude rubber. So by addition of acetic acid, that coagulation will take place, and you will get the solid mass. And that solid mass, coagulated product, is known as crude rubber. Number two. The crude rubber is composed of 90 to 95% rubber hydrocarbon, that is C5H8 isoprene unit, 2 to 4% proteins, 1 to 2% resins, and the latex diluted to 15% of the rubber content, and the coagulation is carried out by removing the negative charge on immersion particles by an electrolyte, usually 1 to 2% acetic acid. So to remove the electrical charge, again it is treated with 1 to 2% acetic acid, alcohol, and also formic acid. The acetic acid diluted to 4%, and the pH range should be between 5.05 to 4.77, and then mixed with latex. No coagulation will occur if acetic acids added in excess. If suppose excess acid is there, coagulation will not take place. So in that case, we have to check the pH range very carefully, and the addition of acetic acid should be very carefully so that coagulation should take place. When the rubber is coagulated to soft white mass, it is called coagulum, is washed, and it is then treated from preparing smoked rubber, crepe rubber, and gutta percha. So from this coagulated rubber material, we will be preparing three types of rubber, and those rubbers are smoked rubber, crepe rubber, and gutta percha. And number three, the rubber hydrocarbon form a sheet on the surface and separated out in the form of sheet. The sheet is squeezed by sweet rolls to expel the absorbed serum, and the bulk of the rubber which is sent to the market in the form of the smoked rubber sheet, and it is coagulated rubber which is washed, shaped with rollers, and put on drying for 8 to 10 days at 45 to 50 degree centigrade temperature. The smoked sheets are pressed and marketed. The pale crepe rubber is made by adding sodium hydrogen sulfide, that is NaHSO3, to the latex before coagulation. The coagulated mass is washed and passed through speed rollers to remove serum, and the sheets are dried without smoking. So with this, the properties of latex and the formation of rubber by coagulation process is over. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.